Yeah, guys. Okay, so what I thought I'd do is do a little sort of a walkthrough of me editing the pre-show triple threat for the XWF Legacy CPV. I've got a bit of a cold, so bear with me. But I thought I'd just show you sort of how much effort it takes to actually edit together that sort of match. So I've got Legacy in progress here. By the time this video comes out, this show would be out. But I've got the footage for the triple threat. As you can see, it's in 25 individual parts. So I'm going to start chucking it together. Let's see what we got. So obviously part one is going to be entrances. So we've got Jacob Drake coming out first. I'll start it there. We'll have a camera cut from Bear at some point where he sort of says next up is the triple threat. Although last show, actually, Boiling Point, I just started straight in with Reverend Dow's music. I thought that worked quite well. But we'll see how we go, Let's get the music there. Okay, so we've got to get this music to a decent volume so you can still hear the crowd over it. There you go, that's good. Come on, everybody. So let's let Drake come down. Everyone hates him. Little top that says Drake is Legacy to go to CPV. And his boxer shorts, say please. I don't know why I put that there, but it made me laugh at the time. So we'll get through this, get his entrance. Now what I often do if I don't want to drag shows out too long is I'll snip the entrances down, especially if they've got a long one. But seeing as this is pre-show and it's Jacob Drake and he's a heel, I'll probably let this entrance run to the full because it's not too long-winded. So I'll let him do his thing. That's fine. Yeah, we'll let him have a little shout at the crowd and stuff. Let him get ready for his next one. So this is the point where he's gonna, I like to give him enough time to take their clothes off. You know, if they're gonna have the jacket and bandana and stuff. So we'll see how long that runs before he's, because at this point he's taking his dog tags off, he's taking his jacket off, he's taking his bandana off. See, that's too quick for me. That's too quick. He hasn't done that in that time. So what I'll do is, before that cuts there, I'll extend this crowd audio from this one. And I'll go to my commentary folder, get a little Bear footage out. Just delete the audio from that, and we'll just splice in a little bit of Bear footage just to extend that time, so he's got enough time to take off that entrance gear. You know, have a little bit of Bear speaking, ladies and gentlemen, I'm the Bear. You know the deal. Let him have a bit of that. And that then, in my eyes, gives him enough time to have removed his entrance gear. Oh, is that it? Is that all? Okay, fine. We'll extend that. Oh, there's not much there, is there? It's fine. So what we want to do then, if that's towards the end of the entrance there, we'll tail off the music. Now if it feels too abrupt quite often, that feels fine to me. So we'll grab Junction's music because he's out next. And Junction's music actually has an intro that I don't use, so it sort of ends there. So we'll grab that. Just shut the start off so we get the. Okay, so we just need to get Junction's music in position. That's good. That's pretty good. We'll go with that. Get the volume right with the crowd. Compare that to Drake's a second. Yeah, that's pretty good. Cool. Now, what we're going to have is we're going to have a jump start, as we have with Hazard at every show so far. So I'm going to stop it here. The jump start comes earlier than that. So we'll go to part two, which should be the footage where I have hazard begin the jump start for Junction's entrance. So it starts sort of here. So we'll grab hazard there. We want to sort of bring hazard in around here. And then he starts doing his little rundown. Music's still playing. And what I've done for part three is I've got some custom camera angle so that we, you know, you can't see that there's going to be a transition where Junction actually turns around and attacks in the back. So we'll grab this little angle here, because that's quite a nice one. Cut that there. Delete the audio track. Just going to chuck this on top and see how that sort of comes together. There you go, yeah, I like that. That's good. So we'll maybe just get a few of these frames. I don't want to see too much. Maybe like here. Cut that. We'll cut that back. And then what I've done is I've gone into the game. I've started the match with no ring on, ring count on, and I've sort of replicated this running so that I could get a better camera angle using the highlight rule, which is here, where you're going to see lesser Junction. So we're going to grab some of this. Sort of want it to be where's the good place? Let's try moving it in there. So that works pretty well. At which point we're actually gonna have Hazard running. The last frame's gotta look like he's still running. I'll bring part three back in. At which point I've obviously recorded some footage where we're on the stage and Junction's gonna hit him and catch him off guard. Because, you know, he's anticipated this, because Hazard does this at every at every CPV. And he's gonna hit him with the blue thunderbolt. At which point we want to stop the music for the impact, you know. But I find this wind up to the move is so slow that I like to sort of grab these first few frames and add a bit of speed to it to make it look like you're snapping it in, bang, you know? Just put a bit more speed on. It can look a little bit unnatural, but it's better than the slow build up. Bang, straight in, and then we'll go back to normal speed for the rest of the move. That's much better. We'll stop the music sort of mid-move, so you get the sound impact from the blue thunderbolt. Dead stop there, so it's like boom! We can leave Hazard, sell him, get the little taunt from Junction that I recorded. And Junction's going to make his way to the ring and just leave Hazard lying. I'll stop it there, and I should have got some custom angles of Hazard selling. So we want that sort of patched in the time that Junction's walking to the ring. Here's the sell from Hazard. Now, the annoying thing is, with the highlight reel, it doesn't drag the audio. I mean, it used to do this on the old game, so I've got no idea why it doesn't do that. So you just get dead silence. So what I tend to do for that is I cut the audio from the highlight reel footage. Get some cheering with no sort of fight sounds. So, like, you know, the crowd are invested here. And I'll just make a copy of that and splice it over. strap that in there. Stretch it out, and then you're going to have sound there when he's selling, which is more natural. Hazard selling, that's good. And then what we want is, I've caught some footage of junction sort of. There's some more selling there. Do we want to get his expression just to sell it? Let's get a bit of that as well. Obviously, again, we're going to have to stretch out this audio if we want to sell the facials. There's always that weird little drop-in animation. There you go. That's better. So Hazard's selling. He's got his comeuppance, which is what he deserves. And then we want some custom angles of Junction going to get in the ring to actually start this match. So I'll grab it from there, because that sort of gives him time after Hazard selling to get him in the ring, and he rolls in. He looks ready. So we'll cut that back. We'll stretch the audio again from that. So we got crowd, Hazard selling, Junction gets in. And we'll swap to part four, which is, I believe, sort of like the intro of the match. So we got some crowd, we'll splice that in. That should have audio as well. Gives Junction time to get his stuff off. That's too quick though. So what we'll do is, we'll put another bit bear in there to fill the gap. Where is it? There it is. Chuck some bear in, extend the audio here, so we got crowd noise to go with it. Little dance, classic. Blah blah blah, and that will give Junction enough time to, you know, realistically take his gear off and get ready for the match. And there we are. So then we'll start this match. I've started this as a singles match because Hazard's out of the way. Bell rings. Now part five should actually be the match footage. So if I don't like how the match starts, I retake, and I'll keep retaking until I get a good flow. It depends on the match. Some matches I will plan the spots out on a notepad file and just work through them and then splice them together. Or this, I sort of know where I'm going, but I'll just wing it, and I'll keep recording until I get a good take, and then once I'm in the moment, I'll just go with the flow, but see how I go. So this take here is obviously one which I've decided on. So we'll go from Jacob Drake being ready here. We'll splice this episode in, this footage in, which is where we're ready for the match to start between these two as a singles for now. And there you go. So I wasn't happy with that start. So let's cut that one off and see what we got here. Now, for a start, if this is the one I'm going to use, which it isn't, because I've started again. And I'm going to tell you now, I probably don't like the way Junction started that, because it's not in character, I need to change that. So I've cancelled that. Let's see what we got here. Is this going to be the one? Flapjack, are we going to start that way? I think we are. Okay, yeah, cool. So, is this little part here compatible? Yeah, it's cool. We go with that. So let's just watch this unfold, and I'll edit as we go. So at this point, when I'm recording, I've got the two controllers on my lap for this. And I'm obviously controlling both characters, so I can control the pace, who's in the lead. So I'll have the other hand on a controller to quickly push the reversal button when I need to reverse. You know, because I want it to stay competitive at this point, because it's early and both guys are proficient. So Jacob gets straight, getting a bit of control there. Nice. Reversal of the suplex. Ooh, nice kick. So when I'm editing a part like this, I'll normally just leave it to run, and you'll probably see in the footage, if I do something I don't like, I'll retake that spot, but for now, it's pretty fine. Experience. So there you go, I've missed the spot there. I missed the toe kick and I've retaken the spot. Now I'm pretty sure that I decide against this section here, so this is just off memory. I'll go back to here where Junction misses the splash. And I'm pretty sure at this point I've decided I'm gonna clothesline him over the top rope. Which I try multiple times and fail by running him into the corner instead. So I just line him up better. Excuse me. Or do I go? Oh no, okay, so I don't clothesline him. I do a running strong Irish whip. So I've just got to make sure this splices together. You'll probably notice in quite a lot of my stuff, you're going to get these cuts here where I decide I want something else done. So I try and make it as smooth as possible. I mean, that's fine. It's not ideal. I might be able to sort of blend the frames a little bit better. Let's see what I got here. So there's one where he goes for the kick. That could be the start of a running animation. It's not, but you'll see what I mean. It might fit together slightly better than It's fine. It's the best I can do. Irish whip over the top. Goes to grab him. And Junction does a nice little body splash there. For the cover. Right, so that there is going to be a transition to the next part. So what I'll normally do is I'll put a cut at the point of impact because I know I've probably gone into highlight reel to get a custom angle of that. Maybe I haven't. All right, that is something I would normally do. So we'll just take that, clothesline over the top, and that there will be the transition to part 6, which is where I've gone out of the game. And I've made another singles match between Hazard and Junction. Because I've essentially written Jacob Drake out of the picture for now, so that I can work with these two for a bit. So what I'll do to soften that transition is I'll bring in the old commentator footage again. There it is. Pop that in there. Ooh, that's longer than I thought. Pop that in there. Drag this audio as much as we can. And then we can bring in this. Now, I'm pretty sure I retook this little section a couple of times because I couldn't get it exactly how I wanted it. See how we go. Sometimes if my takes go wrong loads of times, I'll just delete the video and start again. So this is probably what I've done here. So we're going to start with Hazard getting in as sort of Junction's turning around from lining Drake out. I mean, you know what? You might even get away with not having the bear there. Let's just try that. So, actually, yeah, that works really good. We'll go with that. We'll keep that audio there so we've got the crown cheer from Drake getting clotheslined out. And then we'll just transition back to the audio from this. Sorry, excuse me again. So, let's just see how this plays out. Nice drop kick. Hazard taking control. A little bit back and forth from these guys. Nice net breaker for the cover. Rope break. Junction gets his feet on the ropes. Ah, see, there you go. I've missed a spot there because that stupid little spike headbutt animation, and saying that, it looks like I'm actually about to retake that whole chunk. So maybe this part 6 is redundant. We're about to find out. I can't remember. I recorded this footage yesterday. Yeah, okay. So part 6 is gone. It replaced with part 7. So let's have a little look. Again, we're probably going to get away with, because you can't see the bottom of the ring here. When Jake goes out the ring, Jacob Drake goes out the ring. So if I've got some footage of sort of Junction facing away as Hazard comes in the ring like this, that transition's a lot smoother from Drake being lined out of the ring. So let's check it out. There you go. See what I mean? That works perfectly. So as you can see here, this part 7 is very similar to part 6. I've just reshot how I wanted it. I wasn't happy with how it came out. So this bit here, it's not exactly the same. As I said, I go with the flow a lot on these matches. Some I pre-plan a lot. This one, I've just gone on the flow with what's felt right. And I wasn't happy with that sort of section there. So we've moved on to recording 7, which is where I've reshot that whole section. So let's see how this plays out. Oh, I do like that Hazard Tornado DDT, gotta say. So that was an accident. I would have liked a pin there, but I'll sell that on the commentary. I'll say, you know, Junction ring awareness, grab the bottom rope. I'll make a positive out of it. Trying to keep it fast between these two. You know, like the pre-show triple threat that I did for Boiling Point was fast-paced, and I think it was beneficial for it. So there's a clothesline out of the ring. So I'm assuming that, I can't remember because I recorded this yesterday, is going to be a transition. Well, I mean, it's the end of that video. So let's grab part 8 and see what I've recorded here. So as you can see, I've gone back to... I've obviously backed out of this singles match now that Hazard's out of the ring. Because you can't see the top of the ring. Drake's behind this apron at the top, you know, like out of view, obscured. So what I've then done here, I've started another singles match between Junction and Jacob Drake, and I've just lined him out the ring at the start to get this sort of animation of him getting back up, and I'll cut that down, chuck that on the end, so that as soon as Hazard gets lined out the ring, you're gonna see Jacob Drake getting up to get back in, like that. And I've purposefully used this sort of really close in camera angle so that you can't see Hazard, and that gives him time to sort of get out of view, as it were. So we'll cut that there. And then if we've got enough, we'll drag this audio to obviously give us we haven't. Okay. So let's just hear that crowd sound a sec. I'll cut from there to there, where there's not much bumping noises. Place that in there. So Hazard goes out the ring, bang. And then we'll move this audio up, just so that it bleeds better. There you go, that's better. Drake gets up, it's back in the ring. We'll cut that there. And then we'll carry on with this part 8 footage, which should be, I believe he runs in and tries to schoolboy pin him. Oh no, wait, does he? I think I had a few goes at what I wanted to do with this. As you can see, I do spend a lot of time pissing around trying to get stuff right. Okay, that looks like what I went with. So, Jay gets in the ring. And this is as Junction sort of turning around after seeing what he's done to Hazard. So we want Jacob Drake sort of running at him off guard. And he's going to scoop him out for that pin. So he gets in. Turns around, scoops him over. The only issue I've got there is you can actually see Junction's feet there. So what I might do is cut that there. And... I think that works. The animation doesn't quite match, but we'll see how it plays out in speed. That's fine to me. So he scoops the legs out for this pin. Try and steal it. Kick out. And then we'll let this play out for a little bit. Jacob Drake getting some heat on Junction. Headlock takeover. Rolls him through. I like that animation because it looks like they're still fighting. Looks like they've still got, you know, hope. You got to give them hope. But this is a heat section at this point. So this is Jacob Drake just wearing down on Junction, but he's gonna get his hope spot in a sec, which is, I believe, here. There you go, knee on the top, and then we get a nice hope spot. Neckbreaker. for the cover. So obviously a big part of booking this match is to keep Junction strong. As you I mean, if you've seen the match, you know Junction doesn't go over, but I wanted to make him look strong throughout. So he doesn't take the pin, and B, he gets a lot of offence in. Oh, vintage. There you go. Stomp on the face. Classic Jacob Drake for the cover. And a shoulder up. Reverse tornado DDT. Nice. Okay, so more action from these two. That looks to me like a clothesline over the top rope opportunity. Well, I've stopped the footage here, so I'm not sure why. Maybe I had to answer the door or something, I don't know. Let's see where number 9 is. So number 9 is Hazard coming back in. That's questionable. Why is that? Okay. So, Drake goes for the splash. Junction runs in, hits him with that clothesline. At which point, it looks like Hazard's going to get onto the top rope. So I've backed out of this game at this point and said, no, right, new match with Hazard and Junction, so I can capture this footage here. So we've got Hazard climbing up here and getting onto the top rope, which again we're going to need audio for because it's straight out of highlight reel. Grab some of that from here. We don't want that punch sound, so we'll just grab that for now. Hopefully that's enough. If not, well, we'll grab some more. So chuck that in there. Hazard comes in. Obviously you can see I've used highlight reel to try and directly mask the fact that I'm in a singles match here. There's no Jacob Drake in this footage. So what we'll do is we'll use the actual footage where you can't see Jacob Drake for the audio simply, because Junction is going to grab him straight off the top rope. We want that to happen like as soon as he gets on there, like Junction has noticed him trying to climb up. Throw him straight off, boom. So we've got the sound file there from the in-game footage, and then he's going to throw him straight out of the ring, I believe. Or was he going to try and line him out? I don't know. Either way, we'll stop there. So we've got the audio. We'll go into the highlight reel, and you're going to see that I'm going to purposefully obscure the fact that Jacob Drake is not in the footage, so that you, as far as the viewer is concerned, Jacob Drake is still in the footage. He's still in the match. So we'll cut all this out. We've got the audio here. This has no audio. So we'll cut. Wait, how much left in this footage? It's all highlight reel. So remove this redundant audio. And I can sort of splice this footage over the top here where as and when I want. So I'll move that above. So it's going to go straight from there into Junction grabbing him. But throwing him down. We want to shorten that to just so the sound's in line. Grabs him straight away. Boom. Bumps him over. Hazard sells and sits up. Junction goes to grab him. Purposefully done so that you can't see that Jacob Drake sort of rolled out of here. And you know, as far as the viewer's concerned. Now for some reason, I stop here. So I'm interested to see what part 10 is. Let's see what part 10 is. Ah, okay. So what I've done is I've started the match again with finishers, so that I can have an oh my god moment, just so I can get this little throw out. I've done his whole OMG move, but I'm not going to use it as part of the match. I'm literally just using it for the get out the ring, which is fine. And that comes with sound file. There you go. So that is literally going to go on the end of this. So Drake's going to pick him up. Junction's going to pick Hazard up, and then I'm going to transition straight into that OMG. Where is it? From here. Sort of. How well does that go together, though? That's the question. I sort of. See, this is where I've got to sort of try and get this to match up as good as I can. I think that worked there. I mean, it's not perfect, but I mean, when you're watching a match, it's so fast-paced, you can sort of get past the fact that Junction's going to change position a little bit and just throw him out. So we'll go with that. We'll keep the audio. And then as the camera flies back up, just go back a frame. So in this sort of this camera turn here, I think that's actually the end of part 10, realistically. I don't think anything else happens apart from the OMG move, which I'm not going to use. We'll then bring in... Oh, wait a sec. We'll then bring in part 11, which is going to... It's back to another singles match between these two, Jacob Drake and Junction. And you can see I give Junction a little... I give him a little punch to turn him round so that he's essentially looking at Hazard as he's throwing him out. At which point, the best thing is this is obscured down here at the bottom of the screen. So Hazard's out of view now. He's been thrown out of the ring, and I don't have to worry. Like, the viewer's forgotten about him. At which point, Jacob Drake's going to hit Junction, turn him around, and go straight into his comeback, which is a nice little sort of transition. So if we chuck that on the end, the whole thing is going to look like this. Clothesline. Hazard comes in, goes onto the top rope, as if he's going to try and jump on Hazard. Junction. Junction turns around, throws him off, grabs him, dumps him back out the ring, get out, turns around. Oh, Jacob Drake straight back on the attack. And I think that works pretty nicely. Sling blade. And obviously for a near fall. So the way I'm trying to book it is sort of like Junction, because he's the only face in the match. Although none of them like each other. Right, that right there is an oversight for me, because that's Jacob Drake's finisher, and he's got it as a strong grapple, and I've done it and gone, what? So we're going to have to change this. So what happens is Drake picks Junction up. Sorry, what I was saying was... Jacob Drake and Hazard are both heels. So I'm trying to, even though they don't like each other, I'm trying to have Junction be the guy that's almost trying to take both of them on. Like, as soon as Hazard tries to get back in, Junction throws him out, focusing on Jacob Drake, and then he's hitting the back, you know. That's sort of the way I keep booking the match. That's what I wanted. So Junction never looks weak. Either way, so we've got this Drake break here, which is in his strong move set. I need to go back and change that. I still haven't done that. But so what you can see here is I've done it, and I've gone, oh man, what the hell? So I've picked Junction up, done this little walk into him, which wakes him up, and repositioned, and then I'm going to go for another strong grapple and get one that I want. There's a body slam there. Do I want that? So yeah, I'm not sure I liked that segment. I think I'll pick him up and go for it again. Yeah, there you go. So what have we got? That's a much better spot. Right, so what I'll do here, and you'll notice this in XWF, you probably noticed it already, but what I tend to do if I want to reshoot a spot is I'll just stop here, cut out that middle section, move it in, and hope that the transition's smooth. Like, that's fine to me. Like I say, they're so fast-paced. You can see the cut, but I don't think it affects the... I don't think it affects it. Shoulder up there. Junction moves out the way. What's he go for? An Irish whip of his own. Big forearm. Now I'm pretty sure I fluffed this bit up. Like, I really liked this whole leg drop to the outside. Comes in, does his little Eddie Guerrero for the pin. Yeah, look, I tried to get a near fall and I actually pinned him. I was like, fuck's sake. So I reshot that exact spot because I really liked it. So what I'll maybe do is go from where he goes to do his little Eddie Guerrero. Once his butt's down in the ground there. Because my number 12 video is basically a reshoot of this exact spot. And if I grab it from that same sort of place, stick that in there, it's not going to make too much of a difference. See what I mean? The ref moves. Like, you're going to see these XWF's fucking warping referees in my footage, because I do it all the time. But what I can do is, if I look at where the ref is for this pin here, I can maybe keep the original and go for the pin. And I think when he pulls the leg up, you won't notice the ref warp as much as the one where I was going to, you know, splice in the Eddie Guerrero move. So if we go from here, you still notice it, but I mean, there's not much I can do about it at this point. The only other option would be to see where the ref is for the forearm smash earlier on, before this. So when Junction hits him with that forearm, bang, I could potentially use this version of that. And that actually might be the better option. Clocks him there. Let's move that in there. Let's see how this looks for that. He's over there, though. Does he get... Because he obstructs the view, I'll go with it. Because Junction's sort of in the way. I mean, you're going to notice it. But like I say, it is... I've got no other option at this point. And that kind of works. Hits him with that leg drop. Comes back in for the Eddie Guerrero combo dive in. I'm pretty sure that's a near fall. And he kicks out. Junction taunts him up. Let's delete that bit there. I went to grab him and he sort of transitioned. I got him too early, look. I got him too early. I thought he was up to his feet and he went back down. And then I need him in the face and he gets straight back up. So part 13 is going to be sort of like a reshoot of whatever happened there. Did I actually redo the whole spot again? I did. Okay. Where was the ref for that forearm? One, two, kick out. Taunts him up. Does he fork in the road him? He does. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll go for the fork in the road spot. And I'll maybe just stick that once he's taunted him up here. Again, you're going to get that sort of little edit cut, but... So what we'll do is we'll go from Jacob Drake on one knee and hand trying to get up to his feet. Oh. Drag this out. Where was he getting him up? Where was he doing the wake up taunt? One hand and knee. So that should sort of, again, you might get a disappearing ref, but it's part of the business. That don't work too bad. We'll go with that. Now I'm standing here trying to push signature and my controller's not registering it, which is bloody annoying because it's unnatural. So again, we're going to use another cut. As he gets up, I'm just going to cut it there. Ignore all this sort of messing around here and just go straight to the animation, and you're probably going to get a little cut, but I think it looks better than just standing around. So bang, that works well. Fork in the road, lovely jubbly. Then he's going to go for his frog splash, at which point I cut, so I'm pretty sure you know what's happening. We're going to bring Hazard in to be a little rascal, be a little weasel like he does. Part 14, and there he is. So I started another singles match here. When I record these and I say, I decide, right, Junction's going up top and I want Hazard to come and block it, I stop the match and start a new match. So that this has been quite time consuming just for this, however long this match turns out to be, probably about 10 minutes. So again, I've got highlight reel footage of Junction running in, but I've got the original footage here, so we'll use that. Obviously Jacob Drake's not in the scene, but I'll use it for simply for the audio file. So here's Hazard running in, which is not what I want. I want him to get on the what even did I do here? Okay, so he just gets on the apron, that's fine. So we use the audio from there as he gets up onto the apron and runs along. There's a bloody count out there though, that's so annoying. I forgot to turn the ring out off. Just cut it there so we don't get the referee. Okay, yeah, so we'll keep the audio, delete the video there, and then we'll use the highlight reel footage over the top of that audio so we don't lose any sort of background sound. And again, I've obscured the angle using highlight reel so that you can't see this is a singles match. You can't see that Jacob Drake is no longer in the footage. And Hazard gets on the apron. We'll cut that there. Move that into place. As Junction's getting on the top rope. And annoyingly, this audio's... I'm going to pull it back a little bit. Hopefully that gives me enough. Hazard gets on the top rope, at which point he's going to dump Junction off the top rope so he can't do his frog splash. Or is he going to kick him? Ah, even better. And then dump him. Alright, we'll go with that. So we'll pull that through again so we can get the audio simply. And what I'll do is I'll make that a little bit better, so as he runs there we'll drag it so that the animation sort of like runs over, grabs him, pushes him. Or do we want the kick? I quite like the kick, and it sort of works well with that running animation there, so we'll go with that. So he comes up, runs in, Bosch kicks him, bang, throws him off. Right, we'll go with that. And then he's going to go on the top rope. And I've paused it there, obviously, to capture the highlight reel footage so we can obstruct the fact that Jacob Drake's not in the match. And we'll grab... So this is that exact same spot in the highlight reel. Bang, kicks him. Bang, throws him off. Why have I reshot that? Did I want a better angle or something? I wanted the camera focused on Junction so that it falls down with him when he goes down. Cool. So we'll grab that. Cut out this first bit. Bang, kicks him. Bang, dumps him. Junction goes down. And then I'm going to obviously have cut to the camera again on focus on Hazard so you can see him climbing up to the top. Throws Junction down and climbs up. Bring that through there. Bang. Bang. Climbs up, gets ready, cut the audio from both of those because obviously there is none from the highlight reel footage. Draw that out, grab these two, and these can just go directly over the original footage, so it should link up with the audio that way. Bang, throws him off, climbs up top, and again the whole time I'm obstruct, because that was used for is that spot there. And from here you can't see Hazard, he's off screen. This still feels like a triple threat. Hazard comes up, you still are under the impression Jacob Drake's in the ring, kicks him because I've obstructed the view. You know, Jake's he's further away from what you can see, and you buy into that. Hazard goes to the top rope and then he does his little body splash and goes for the cover, which is a kick out. So again, we'll use the original footage from here. To dive, go straight from here to his frog splash, body splash, sorry, hit it. Now annoyingly that splash doesn't have a press circle for cover option straight from it. So what I do, again it's messy but it works, is go from this sort of still kneeling, I've pushed circle to pin, and I'll just cut and drag that back to sort of make it look like you've landed the splash, bang, straight into a pin. It's not perfect if you look at the animation. If you pull that through, you see what I mean? But in the moment, in the speed of it, you go, bang, cover. It works. One, two, three, and that's a kick out. So we got the audio there. I've gone to highlight reel, so again, we can capture footage that isn't going to show that Jacob Drake is not in the match. And it goes from sort of here. And that splash goes bang. And I wanted a better angle where you can see a bit more hazard. Big splash. Is that the one? Bang. And then the pin there. Okay, that's fine. So we're going to sort of go from here with the big splash. Bang, hits that. And then, if you remember, we spliced it sort of when he lifted his arm up there. And we're going to change the camera angle in highlight reel, and the pin's going to come straight from it. So it goes, bosh, lands on him, straight into the cover. One, two, and a big kick out. And we'll stop it there. Remove both these audios. And again, I can just put these directly over the top of the original in-game capture, and you should get the sound in place. Bang for the cover. Where's the ref? One, two, three. And a kick out. Perfect. Cut that there, and then we're going to go to part 15, which is okay. So I've done a triple threat here with two controllers, so I'm relying on AI heavily to do what I want it to do, because I've needed all three of them in the ring for this. Oh, you're kidding me. Do I break the pin? I broke the pin. Okay, that's fine. I completely forgot. So, we want to hit him with a splash. Go, one, two. Now, if you notice, very annoyingly, this is a lateral press pin. Whereas, this animation here is actually a leg hook, and I've obviously not cottoned onto that when I'm recording. So, what we're going to do is, we're going to have Drake break it at the last second to try and obscure the fact that it's a leg hook. It's like one, three, bang. See what I mean? It's so quick, you don't even notice that it's a leg hook. Three, bang, breaks the pin. That works. Now, I remember having a bit of trouble with what I wanted to do next here. So, I think I'm going to clothesline him out of the ring. I'm going to put a cut there just to be sure, just for safety. But let's see what I actually did. So, well, I've got a custom angle for that. Do you want to use that? Because that obscures the leg hook even better. I don't know, actually. I quite like the in-game footage break. I think that worked quite well. Bang. We'll go with that. Now, what do I actually do here? Do I line him out the ring? Or I cannot remember. Ah, look. See, this is the triple threat problem, man, because Junction starts getting up, and he's AI, so I have to restart the match. Repeat, you know, get him into position where I want him. I put him on easy mode, obviously. Put him where I want him. Started doing moves by accident. Get him down. Put him where I want him. So he's there because he's just been pinned. Drake breaks the pin. I've tried to sort of reshoot that moment. Ran straight into him. What's the money? Junction gets up. Yeah. Bang, bang, bang. He breaks the pin. Right, so it is a clothesline over the top rope, which is going to take Hazard out of the picture. So if we go break the pin, bang, and that's going to line him out. Again, it's not going to be tidy, but it's going to be so quick that you might not even notice. Bang! So, body splash, one, two, Drake breaks it. jumps over, bang, clothesline over the top rope. And then Drake goes for the cover as well, off of the body splash. So I'm still in a triple threat, so that you've got Hazard at the bottom of the screen out of view, like still in view, to give that illusion that it's still a triple threat, you know, 1, 2, 3. Because I find when I do a triple threat, as long as you've got a couple of scenes where all three are in at once, that helps with the sort of immersion of it. Junction kicks out. And that's where I've stopped that footage. Is that to get highlight reel footage? I bet it is. It's going to be the clothesline over the top rope, isn't it? No? What am I doing here? Am I reshooting it to get better sort of clothesline over the top rope? I reckon that is all I got from 15, you know, is that clothesline and that pin. Let's see where 16 is. So you can see I've gone back into a singles match and I've basically got to the same position. Like, I've used this legacy on the floor, on the canvas, to sort of line up. Junction's head was on the E. And I've sort of tried to get him into that position, and then I've pushed record again. So if I bring that in here, what you're looking at is I've gone back to a singles match. But because the bottom of the ring's obscured, you can't see Hazard, so the illusion is that he's still there. So Drake gets up. And then look, I mean, that transition is perfect. Like, you almost, that feels like the same match, but that's two separate matches. So we're back to a singles match. And I've wanted to get that comeback spot. I botched it. How can you botch a comeback? Botchamania, that is. So what I've done is I've picked him up and I've gone for it again. And it's obviously worked that time. Now, do I want the little showboating business? Yeah, right, so I can have the showboat. It's quite Jacob Drakey to do this little showboat, isn't it? And Junction stunned. I'm going to keep that in. Bang. He botches it. Sorry, that's the botch version. So we'll go from this little showboat. And then as he swings the punch there, we'll cut out. We'll go back to this version where it's obviously worked. And I'll just get to that sort of rough frame. It's nice because you get a little camera angle shift, actually, when the comeback comes in. So, bang. I just need to draw that punch back a little bit, sort of there. Put that in. Bosh.
So good.
Bosh again.
So funny.
And then I've purposefully not done the comeback because we want Junction to get his little, like, oh, he's back in the game. Turns around. Off the top of my head, this is the sort of time I would use another comeback of my own. But he's got a finisher, so. Do I hit him with a blue thunderbomb? I've probably hit that and just woke him back up because I actually want the comeback spot, knowing me. There you go. So there's the comeback animation. Obviously, we'll cut that out because we want this to go straight back in. We want this to go straight into the clothesline from the comeback. So he goes, he misses. He turns around, bosh, clothesline. Nicely put together. Manhattan drop, pulls the legs out, drops some legs on the stomach. Basement drop kick, nicely done. And then he starts taunting him up for a signature or a finisher. Does he go for it again? Fork in the road again, bosh. And he goes for the cover. And that is 1, 2, 3, and he kicks out near fall. Kicks out the fork in the road. Junction up to his feet, and then I've stopped the camera. So I don't know if I've gone for a highlight reel or... so this is another classic, like, XWF staple. Is where it's a near fall. I want to get this face of Junction disappointed, you know, when they thought they've won. So I normally cut on the three, about there. Get the highlight reel, and then swap to an angle that's going to show you the facial. And cut the audio off that. And bring that in here. So it goes 2, 3. Oh no, he kicked out. And then you see Junction's disappointment in his face. Because he thought he'd done it. And I think that's all that there is for 15. Part 16 here. See, now this is going to be Hazard jumping back in for the springboard. Bosh. And it's a triple threat again. So I've quit out the game. Loaded a triple threat match. And... we've taken out Jacob Drake, who's AI, hit him, put him back in his place where he was. So I've looked at this footage and I've gone, right, he's laying there. Got him up, beat him up, put him there, loaded up, got Hazard here for a springboard. And I sort of just want to have him here so that it's so quick you almost aren't ready for it. That when Junction kicks out the pin and stands up, when Jacob Drake kicks out the pin and stands up, Junction goes springboard in, but Hazard, sorry, goes springboarding straight in and catches him off guard almost. Because. Got a bit of foot. Cut that bleed over there. And he's going to go bosh and catch him off guard. I've walked him into it almost, you know, like classic WWE, bang straight in, hits him with that crossbody. And Hazard's going to, Junction's going to try and crawl away, and Hazard's going to go for the pin for the one, two. Drake's trying to get up desperately, and Junction gets a shoulder up, which is perfect. Now, the AI actually gave me an idea at this point, because Junction kicks out this pin. Right. And the AI controlling Jacob Drake in the background, after the pin, if you watch, right? I mean, I don't know, this is 2K19 AI just crawling around randomly. But he moved into this position, at which point I went... I was recording, I went, mate, he looks like he's ready for a Hazard kick. So this was the AI's concept, man. I didn't come up with this, but I thought that works perfectly. So as you can see, the second I see him in that position there, I move Hazard into this corner. And he starts getting up. And I'm like, oh, he's getting Hazard kicked. So, part 18 is a triple threat again, where I've had to go in and give everyone finishers from the start, hit Junction, who's now AI instead of player 2. I've hit Junction with Jacob Drake's finisher to knock him out. I've put all their health to lows and the time staying down onto very low so that they're not going to get up quick. So we've hit Junction with Jacob Drake's finisher to keep him down. Then I've hit Jacob Drake with some strong grapples to keep him down. And got them into their positions that they were in this capture. Simply so I can push triangle and get a Hazard kick lined up. Which is here. But the cut is dodgy as hell, so let's see if we can get it any good. It's gonna need it. It's gonna. That's probably the best you're gonna get there and there, although it's still not very clean, is it? It's gonna need a commentator cut in there. I haven't had to use one for a little while because it's been they've gone together quite well, but we are going to need one here. Stick that in there. Oh, put it on that one so I can chop it. Let's get a slightly different bit of footage. So that's in there. Bang, bang, bang. Bear getting hyped up. Like, oh my god, he's going to hit him with the Hazard kick. Unlink that. Give us a little bit more audio. Ah, see, that's the sound of the bloody highlight reel. Let's just cut some audio from here. That'll do. Should give us enough ungroup. Oh. Paste it in there. And that right there should be the audio. Like, Bear's like, oh my god, it's gonna Hazard kick him, man, it's gonna Hazard kick him. Pull that in, and then this should line up now, because the Bear obstructing your view is going to stop you from noticing that these guys shift places just slightly. Like, Hazard moves into there and Drake moves from there to there, but the commentary is going to cut that up. So I'm going to be like, oh my god, he's going to Hazard kick him, and you're not going to notice that they move positions. And then obviously he's going to hit him with the Hazard kick, bang, and Drake Junction's still down, and you're going to think, oh man, he's going to steal it. At which point, he got up. He actually got up and broke it. I was like, what? That was perfect. So, he got up and broke the pin. literally like perfect timing. Look at this, 1, 2, bang, and broke it. I mean, that's spot on, really. Now, if I remember correctly, I can't actually remember where I went from here, because it turned into a bit of a shit show. Did I want to keep this section? I can't remember. I can't remember at all. I'm interested to see what part 19 is. Is Junction back in the ring? Please don't have him. I'll tell you what, I actually think this is all sort of still happening while it's... No, it's not, is it? Okay, cut that out for a minute. So where do we go from here? Oh, okay. So, Junction breaks the pin. Cut all this. Junction breaks the pin. And he's going to grab Hazard and throw him out. This cut's going to be awkward as hell, man. So he hits the Hazard kick. Junction breaks it. And then what we sort of want is to grab him and throw him out of the ring.
And this is gonna,
I reckon that's not going
to
be too bad. You put that in there. So he goes, bang, grabs him. Yeah, that's fine. Throws him over the top rope. Gives him a clock. He's gone. And then Junction lifts Drake up and goes into his comeback. But I want this to be fast paced. So I want him to pick him up and straight into the comeback. None of that sort of build up rubbish. So straight in. This one's always got a real slow jump into that line. So if we pull that in there. He goes, picks him up, bosh, clothesline. Wait, what? Oh, sorry, my bad. Picks him up, bosh, clothesline. Fuck, God's sake. Let me just stretch that out. Right, picks him up, bosh, clothesline. Manhattan drop. Pulls the legs out again. Drops that leg drop on him. Pit dual piston drop kick in the face. And Hazard's starting to get up, which kind of works well. Junction forking the road again. Clock hits him with it. Taunts him up for a backfire or a blue thunderbomb. Not sure which one. And then I've gone for a cut. I'm interested to see why I've gone for a cut here. Seeing as when we just looked at 19 a second ago, it was Hazard and Junction, wasn't it? Why have I done that? I'm struggling to see how that fits together. So am I under the impression that we're going to sort of have that edit there I've done is actually pointless with Jacob Drake. Cut that. So I'm under the impression that we're going to hit him. Break the pin. We're going to have another bear section here. Jeez. He's going to be like, oh man, that was so close. Just try and keep your mind off the fact that I'm now going to cut this back to singles and keep Jacob Drake out of the picture for a minute. But oh my god, man, that was so close. And then we'll bring in, it goes back to singles here, where Junction's going to start the comeback. Hazard's going to start the comeback. Bang, bang, bang. Clock, there you go. Bang, pulls the legs out. So we're under the impression that Jacob Drake's rolled out of the ring at this point. You know, he nearly got pinned from the Hazard kick. He's gone out of the picture. And it's now down to these two guys. So big clothesline from Hazard. Goes for that. He blocks it, kicks him off. I'm going to go straight from here into the blue thunderbomb finish. But I decided that I'm going to have Hazard reverse it. So where's the reversal? He hit him with it. Where's the reversal? Ah, there it is. Cool. Right. So we're going to go straight from here into the animation. There. So that when they come out of this animation, it goes straight into the blue thunder bomb over the top. Irish whip over. I miss the Irish whip. I'm like, god damn it. So what I normally do if that happens is just cut. And then just drag where it, do another one, and where at the moment of it, of connect, just pull it together. And you are going to get a slight, you're going to get a slight little thing there, but it works. Over the top. You know what? At that point, I think I decided I'm going to use an oh my god moment for the little throw out the ring, because it looks good. So I'm pretty sure Hazard just slaps him on the chest, and yeah, look, so I've started again with finish. So I've just got to find a way to get this slap into the reversal from this. So he goes over the top, bang, grabs him, and then he does that slap on the chest. It's not super clean, is it? Might have to do, though. It's not ideal. Maybe try it. See how it looks from the Irish whip. Sort of from here, maybe. Does that work better? Bosh. I mean, that kind of works. I reckon it works better from here, to be honest. Blue Thunderbomb over the top. Goes to grab him. And goes, gosh, yeah, we'll go with that. Junction rolls out the ring. At which point, I'm not actually going to do an oh my god moment. I just want that transition of Junction rolling out. Simply so, Jacob Drake can slip in for this sort of, for this roll up pin that's going to come up next. Took me a fucking while to get this pin to work. 1, 2, 3. So that's the one. So yeah, what I've done is I've just done the little turnaround punch just to get him facing away from me, so it looks like he's still sort of reeling off throwing Junction out. And that's then going to go slap him out, bang, he rolls out, and Jacob Drake rolls in for the schoolboy. Kick out. It's not enough. Which point I've gone to 21. So what happens in 21? I'm trying to... Man, I don't know what this glitch is, right? Check this out. This sort of roll-up pin here with the bridge. I tried this about 5 times to get this to work, because I was just going to have a cheeky roll-up at the end, but their arms get connected for some reason. Look, what the hell's going on? So I actually have to go into his moveset and change the fucking move to fix it. Which basically makes that whole recording 21 redundant. Oh, yeah, okay. So he was going to go for the schoolboy. He's going to go for the schoolboy. Hazard's going to kick out. And then as Jacob Drake's getting up, I was going to have Junction climb up onto the apron to try and get back in the ring after being thrown out. Which has required me to go back into another singles match with these two, just for this spot. So he climbs up. And Drake's going to kick him off. He's trying, you know, Hazard threw him out. He's getting back in to stop it. Getting back in. And Jacob Drake is going to drop kick him off the apron. Like that. Goes to grab him. Drop kicks him off the apron. Junction's out of the picture. Get a better angle of that. Console here. And grabs him, drop kicks him off, bang to the outside. Better camera angle again. He's up, bang, grabs him, drop kicks him to the outside, bang. We need to get the audio file for that still. Junction's selling on the outside because he's just taking a flat back bump on the concrete floor. And I think that's literally all I did that singles match for, just to capture that, like, half a second. But I do need the audio from that, so let's get that.
Yeah, like literally lost my face.
So that's the sound file there as Junction's getting up. So sort of from here through till he gets drop kicked, and the flat back bump. Big sound. Unlink that. Drag that in there. And that should now link in properly. Bang, grabs him. Is that thump? Comes a bit early, doesn't it? Let's try that. Yeah, that works. I mean, it's not perfect, but you're not going to notice that in a moment. So he's going to kick out the pin. Junction's going to try and get back in. He's going to drop kick him off. Bang, out goes Junction. At which point, I think, if I remember correctly, because I was going to have Hazard roll him up and win at that point.
Yeah, you can change.
I did it, obviously. And I did it, and I wasn't happy with it, because I thought, it's a bit anticlimactic. Although, it's a heel way to win. But I wanted a full stop, exclamation mark, you know. So I've gone into a singles match with Hazard and Drake. Punched him to turn him around. So he's still almost focused on the Junction. Drop kicking him out of the ring. At which point, crucifixion. For the cover. False finish. Kick out. Pick him up. God, I'm trying to remember what comes after this. Oh, that's it. So Drake's going to go for a Drake break. Got to get them false finisher moves in. You know. He's going to go for it. Push my way. We can get a cleaner cut on that. So we want to sort of pick up and then straight into that finisher attempt. Like that. So it's like, sort of like, maybe even quicker. Maybe even before he lets go of his head, he's going to go straight into it. So it's like, pick him up. Oh, Drake break. No, he pushes him away. And then I ran at him and I thought, it's got to be a hazard kick and a finish. Like just out of nowhere. Out of nowhere, hazard kick. So I've gone for that. Forward step there, run, and I know for sure that I've backed out the game. Or have I already? No, they've already got finishers. That's fine. I already gave him finishers from the start. Or does he? Does he try and roll him up first? Yeah. Okay. So I was gonna go for the schoolboy finish, which is a nice sort of just heel roll through. He's gonna get him. Disappointing. But then I decided, actually no, I want the hazard kick finish. I want a clean finish. So I've gone in and I've recorded a hazard kick. But that's too close range, I decided against it. So I've started the match again. Put him down over here. Lined up the hazard kick while he's a bit further away. There it is. So we don't want the whole build up, we just want the running and the kick and the sound effect. So it's going to go, push him away, bang. Obviously once I use the highlight reel, this is going to look cleaner, but his foot, sort of right foot is there at that point, which is going to work pretty well for this. So pull that in, push him away, bang. Hazard kick. I mean, you could get away with even just using that, them cuts there without the highlight reel. That's pretty smooth. Bosh. But I am going to use the highlight reel just because it adds that sort of exclamation point on the end of the match. What's the best angle for this? I captured quite a few, but I'm pretty sure I remember the last one being pretty good. There it is. Runs in. Bosh. Right, that's a good impact. Look. Clock. So what we'll do is we'll cut that and delete the audio. Where was it? It was the right foot down, wasn't it? So right foot down there. And then we want to cut the audio from this impact. Drop the audio. Drag that over the top. Where was the hazard kick? Goes for the Drake break. Pushes him away. hits him with a hazard kick, sort of. Bosh. I mean, that now covers the fact that the animation of Drake there and there is different because the camera angle obstructs it. And you're not going to... I mean, he puts his hand up taking the attack. That's fine. So, lifts him up. Drake break. Pushes him away. Runs in. Boom. Hazard kick. Takes him out. I mean, that's a smooth transition. And then it's just a pinfall. I mean, that's pretty much where Hazard goes over. Which is not the best way to open the show because no one likes Hazard, but... I want that pin to be sort of snappy, so I want him to sort of go straight into the cover. Even better if I can go from sort of here, so that he goes for the sort of scramble cover. Like that. Let's try that. So he goes, push him away, hazard kick, straight into the cover. That's nice. Maybe even quicker, you know, maybe even just rip a couple of frames off of that. So sort of like there. So it goes, whoosh. Maybe even cut a few frames off this. So it's more of like a desperation sort of... Yeah, there you go, that's better. So it's like, bang, push him away, bop, hazard kick, straight over for the cover, pull the leg up, one, two, three, and Hazard wins. At which point, obviously, we're going to go grab Hazard's music. No, Hazard didn't have music, because he jump-started, as always. Right, so we'll get his music in there. It's going to be loud. Turn the volume down on that. Let me just set my window straight. Oh. Okay, grab the effect controller of that. Bring the volume down so it's more in line with the crowd audio. Maybe sort of like 10 decibels. This song's always really loud, man. Pop that in there. Maybe like 14. Okay, that's too quiet. Let's go 12. That's alright, that works. Bring up the old legacy screen. The problem with that replay, obviously, is that didn't happen like that, because I've spliced two bits of footage together, so, I mean, if I want to keep the replay in, I could just sort of cut it there. Like that. Close that. Delete that one. So it can go legacy, you know, legacy, bang, hazard kick, there it is, there's the finish. But again, this isn't true because I've cut that. So we'll cut the replay out completely. We'll cut the replay out completely and we'll go straight to Hazard celebrating his victory at the Legacy pre-show, much to the dismay of many people. So he does his little celebration. Hazard picks up the victory. Let him finish his little animation. Cut it there. And then what I tend to do is just leave a little tail of the song playing still so that I can put some bare footage over here and sort of get ready for the next match. So I'll cut that. I can extend that if need be. So what we're going to do now is this is our triple threat sort of together in a lot of edited parts, as you can see. And then what I'm going to do is just watch it back. Here comes the jump start, which is failed and spoiled this time because Junction knows it's coming, hits him with a blue thunderbomb. Obviously sell that hard on the commentary. Obviously, there's no commentary recorded yet. Obviously, the version you've seen of this match will have had the commentary because I would have done that by that point. So So basically what I'm doing at this point is just keeping an eye out for any sort of little problems that I hadn't noticed when I was editing it, like maybe a couple of transitions don't look good when you're watching it in one go. And also I'm just sort of keeping track of the pacing of the match and the length of the match to see if it drags too long when you're watching it in one go. But with this sort of match, it's the pre-show, it starts, everyone's sort of raring and ready for a show at this point. They're all on board, so you can get away with sort of dragging it a little bit if you want to. Because it's triple threat, it's quite fast-paced. No one's tired at this point, so I tend to find these matches go down quite well. But yeah, this is pretty good so far. I'm enjoying this. Okay, so I just watched the match back. Pacing's really good. Action's pretty good. I'm happy with it. I've changed literally the tiniest details. Where there was maybe some animations which didn't quite run perfectly, I just shortened or lengthened the video before or after just to make them fit to together as best as they can. But yeah, in general, I'm pretty happy with that. I think that's a good start to the show. Yeah, thanks for watching. I might do more of these sort of things if you guys are interested. If not, no worries.